like to work on that in the beginning and then not slowing down when I go into
Okay, good. So that's great. So the first thing to do with that is show us your grip. There you go. And just like your fingers, and then hang on. And then shake, and bring it up. So that's, a lot of it is grip. The more grip gets like this, the harder it's going to be. And then the key to staying ahead of the group, two things. One is just move side to side.
Okay, rather than like...
Yeah, you can do figure eight or four patterns, something that's going to give you a little more horizontality, and then don't freak out when you're ahead of them.
Okay. Thank you. Morning, everybody. Thanks for a great week. We started from the beginning.
I'm sorry.
I know.
You
said that. Sorry.
So listen. For me, there's a conversation about this. I think we think about this a little bit differently. But for me, I like a bigger handle because then I actually have to keep my fingers around it. For me, if I have too small of a handle, I'm going to tend to do this. But what happened is you're doing this little kind of pinchy thing. Mm-hmm. So again, just think about holding it. Close your hand and just let it. Shake here, you bring it up, and it should, just like that, pop, you'll be, and so if this is a thing that you have some sort of a claw of some sort, just before you start, just go like this, let it hang for a couple seconds, and then bring it up. That's just a good way to fix it. And what I always try to feel, for me, my pinky on the handle of the baton, so that then I'm not doing a little, tea tasting instead of conducting. So, here we go, once again, begin. Verticality and back in the shoulder makes you look slower. It's not a bad way to do the retardando. So you're 1 2 3 1 2 3 1 2 3. By just getting a little heavier, it'll help with the slowdown. But if you're always like this, then you've taken that tool away. They've already discounted it. They've already baked it into what they see, and so it has no power to do anything else. Now I think you're doing a good job keeping the tempo moving, but I feel like every macro shape you're doing is away. Mm-hmm. And a lot of them are out here. So you're like, you're here, your torso's here, the ensemble's there, and you're just kind of out here. So even this is a little better here in the middle because you're conducting. So can you try to conduct through the tip of the baton at the people you want to conduct, as opposed to like my arms are out here? That's thing one. Thing two, may I?
Yes.
Okay. So I feel like you want to do this. This is kind of how you want to show legato. But what if you just went
because with the head, with the knees, it's like trying to feel pulse, mm-hmm. and you're feeling it everywhere except for in your arms.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's try right at when the theme comes in, which is where.
That would be
31.
Great. Let's start at 27. Think about moving through as opposed to pulling away.
Okay.
And if you start to move your body, I will come help you.
27.
Okay, are you conducting through the baton?
No.
Because the baton is where?
Here. It was like
I mean your arm is way to the outside of your body. Set up again. So who are you gonna conduct here?
The upper woodwinds.
Which upper woodwinds?
Flute, oboe, clarinet.
Do you just set all of them? Okay.
Well, yeah.
So point at a person you're gonna conduct at the very beginning. That's JR, okay?
JR.
So will you set up to conduct JR?
Well, they play at 31, sorry.
Okay,
so
well then forget you, JR. So who are you going to conduct on?
That would be the brass, the trumpets, horn.
Choose one.
Trumpets.
Which trumpet?
Andrew.
Okay, great. So set up and look through your baton right at Andrew. Here we go. Not away from one, but towards
two,
right? Not away from two, but towards three. So go on to the next thing. Now, I mean, it's like not like, you know, you're going to make total eye contact. Okay, I'm going to conduct Andrew, then I'm going to conduct Spencer. I mean, sometimes you give things in a general direction.
Mm-hmm.
But if you try to conduct three people at once, how many people are you going to conduct?
None,
right? So in essence, it's like, Katie, you are the representative of the flutes. Boom, boom, boom. And any other flute who's watching will see that I'm conducting Katie, and we'll follow the same thing. As opposed to, I think I'm gonna conduct the upper winds. Yeah, you know, which is just so nonspecific that then it doesn't help.
Mm-hmm.
Same place, and keep going.
27.
Towards, not away.
The trumpet part that I just hear in my mind, and I think it's like a sustain that I feel like they need some drive through the crescendo.
So you want more beats to show that?
Maybe it's just in my mind. I don't know.
What if you did this?
Sure.
So here's why that I'm uneasy about that is because then what are you going to do here?
I'm neglecting the saxophone.
Well, no. So same place. Here's 27. Stay right with me. Here we go. One, two, and. I think you can show the shape, but then still come to them.
Okay, your turn. 27.
Yep. Good job. Since we're out of time, so I'm going to skip to the last thing I was going to say, which is I feel like now also you, when you go like this, your arm is like, ooh. What if you went... One, two, and three. Why don't you look at the tip of your baton?
Sure.
And the good news is, through the tip of your baton, your eyes will meet with the player because the tip of the baton's not out here. You don't want to make a lot of eye contact with Dr. Sedatol and Tyler. You want to make eye contact with the players by looking through your baton.
Sure.
Okay, last time.
27.
Okay,
I feel like everything we talked about, you did, and then it kind of slipped back into the habits. But I felt like when you were moving a little bit smaller, you were still moving smoothly, but keeping the baton between you and the ensemble, as opposed to one, two, way out here, it moved better and it sounded better.
Right.
Okay, good work.
Thank you. Thank you, everybody. Thank you.